So this is my grandfather, may he rest in peace. It's his old service helmet. He gave me this quite a while ago, I think, and it's just kind of been laying around a little bit. But it's kind of a fun little, I guess, historic little memento from before. Yes. Sorry, my neighbors are making noise. I made a couple of videos with this, and I promised one guy who was very interested in the helmet, I promised him that I would make, or sorry, I assume it's him, I shouldn't do that. I promised to them that I should, that I was going to make another video talking a little bit more about the actual helmet itself, and not just tapping on it and such. And I completely forgot about that, and for that I'm sorry. I just, a year went by, I think, and then I, without me doing anything, because I just kind of escaped my mind. But he reminded me of it in the comments, so I figured, let's do it. In terms of, like, the helmet itself, I don't really know all that much about it. I know it's, like, a similar designed the German helmets, but it's not the German helmets, it's the Norwegian ones. Although, I mean, the Germans did occupy Norway under World War II, so maybe there was some cross production, some cross crossing of gear there, I don't know. As you can see here on the side is the Norwegian coat of arms. On both sides, the lion with the axe. There are some holes there in the side, right there, probably for aeration or something like that. I'm not really sure. Inside the helmet is, as you can see, like a little leather. Leather padding. I think the leather has shrunk over the years because it doesn't fit me at all. Maybe my grandpa had a small head. Oh, I also do have a pretty big head, so it's probably those two plus the leather shrinking. But you can see how it's kind of like suspended away from the metal. I wouldn't expect this to be like super comfortable to wear when it does fit, but see how it's kind of padded. And then there's the strap that goes around to tighten the helmet and keep it on. It's quite heavy. I'd say it's about at least a few kilos. Or something like that. So probably wearing this all day would probably make your head and your neck pretty tired. But you know, that's, I think that's at least through their worries for those men and women who wore them. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I mean, as far as what I I don't really know much about what he did or how he served. I'm fairly certain he was never in any active duty. He might just have served inland, you know, in the defense part of the army. But yeah, so that's it. wasn't so bad. I feel like the helmet tappings are pretty cool. I feel like they work. I like sometimes a bit. Let's see if I can put this down quietly. I like sometimes. Lighter.